This show is sponsored by CoinTaker, distributor of brand new, full-size, authentic Stern Pinball, Chicago Gaming, Raw Thrills arcade games, and much more. Also, a full line of dramatic pinball mods, LED flipper kits, speaker lights, custom laser LED toppers, playfield protectors, Bally Williams parts, pinball apparel, and much more. Get the latest releases and glam out your game room with CoinTaker. Everything at your fingertips at CoinTaker.com. Get your game on.
This Week in Pinball is proud to sponsor and present the TWIPY Pinball Awards. Check out This Week in Pinball for weekly pinball news, exclusive game reveals, interviews, deep dives into new game releases, and exclusive content and stories from everything pinball. This Week in Pinball also does over $1,000 in giveaways each and every month from partnerships with Pin Stadium, Pin Sound, Comet Pinball, Titan Pinball, Pinball Photos, Silverball Swag, Pinball Life, PinQuest, Hooked on Pinball, P3 Multimorphic, Stern Pinball, Jersey Jack Pinball, and many more. To be automatically entered to win the giveaways each month and to keep This Week in Pinball going, consider supporting TWIP with a small monthly donation on Patreon. Stay tuned for the TWIPY Pinball Awards. We will be starting shortly.
So we believe that Marco Specialties is perceived in the market as a partner to our customers. We want to be able to give customers confidence that whatever game they run across, they can call us and get that machine working and beautiful again. 30 years ago, before we got started, if you found a pinball machine, people would say, there's nowhere to get those parts. Just, we don't know what to do. And so now, with Marco around, our customers are confident that they can call us and get those games working. Pinballs are little pieces of history. Most games will never get made again, so part of our mission is to make sure that these games are preserved for future generations to play.
Pinball's a special entertainment device. It's kinetic art. It's really not a toy or a game, it's really a medium. And as such, it's open to endless creative talents by the collaborative efforts of the designers and the engineers who make the things.
Pinball is a very limited resource. There's not many machines out there. And so the people that dedicate lots of time and energy into preserving and upgrading and presenting these games to people, and then also letting people play them freely in their communities, those are our favorite and best customers, because they're the ones that are really, you know, carrying the torch for the pinball community as a whole.
People who own pinball machines are the most interesting people in the world. We have a customer list that includes corporate executives, rock stars, sports figures. They all have game rooms, and they all have pinball machines.
We started investing heavily in these pinball community shows that are happening around the world, primarily in the U.S. now, but we're starting to see them grow in the rest of the world as well. And this is where our favorite customers, the collectors that share, bring their games out to a public location and let everyone in the community come out and play for the weekend. It's a really beautiful thing, and we've been spending lots of time and energy of showing up at these shows as well and trying to also bring new games out for people to enjoy and to get those games in people's hands. And we've seen that grow from just a couple of little shows to now there's over 20 shows throughout the country with thousands of games being represented, with hundreds of thousands of people attending these events. And it's just really rewarding to see that we've had at least a small part in the contributing to the success of that aspect of the pinball community as it's been exploding over the last 10 years.
This show is sponsored by CoinTaker, distributor of brand new, full-size, authentic Stern Pinball, Chicago Gaming, Raw Thrills arcade games, and much more. Also, a full line of dramatic pinball mods, LED flipper kits, speaker lights, custom laser LED toppers, playfield protectors, Bally Williams parts, pinball apparel, and much more. Get the latest releases and glam out your game room with CoinTaker. Everything at your fingertips at CoinTaker.com. Get your game on.
This Week in Pinball is proud to sponsor and present the TWIPY Pinball Awards. Check out This Week in Pinball for weekly pinball news, exclusive game reveals, interviews, deep dives into new game releases, and exclusive content and stories from everything pinball. This Week in Pinball also does over $1,000 in giveaways each and every month from partnerships with Pin Stadium, Pin Sound, Comet Pinball, Titan Pinball, Pinball Photos, Silverball Swag, Pinball Life, PinQuest, Hooked on Pinball, P3 Multimorphic, Stern Pinball, Jersey Jack Pinball, and many more. To be automatically entered to win the giveaways each month and to keep This Week in Pinball going, consider supporting TWIP with a small monthly donation on Patreon. Stay tuned for the TWIPY Pinball Awards. We will be starting shortly.
This show is sponsored by CoinTaker, distributor of brand new, full-size, authentic Stern Pinball, Chicago Gaming, Raw Thrills arcade games, and much more. Also, a full line of dramatic pinball mods, LED flipper kits, speaker lights, custom laser LED toppers, playfield protectors, Bally Williams parts, pinball apparel, and much more. Get the latest releases and glam out your game room with CoinTaker. Everything at your fingertips at CoinTaker.com. Get your game on.
This Week in Pinball is proud to sponsor and present the TWIPY Pinball Awards. Check out This Week in Pinball for weekly pinball news, exclusive game reveals, interviews, deep dives into new game releases, and exclusive content and stories from everything pinball. This Week in Pinball also does over $1,000 in giveaways each and every month, from partnerships with Pin Stadium, Pin Sound, Comet Pinball, Titan Pinball, Pinball Photos, Silverball Swag, Pinball Life, PinQuest, Hooked on Pinball, P3 Multimorphic, Stern Pinball, Jersey Jack Pinball, and many more. To be automatically entered to win the giveaways each month and to keep This Week in Pinball going, consider supporting TWIP with a small monthly donation on Patreon. Stay tuned for the TWIPY Pinball Awards. We will be starting shortly.
So we believe that Marco Specialties is perceived in the market as a partner to our customers. We want to be able to give customers confidence that whatever game they run across, they can call us and get that machine working and beautiful again. 30 years ago, before we got started, if you found a pinball machine, people would say, there's nowhere to get those parts. Just, we don't know what to do. And so now, with Marco around, our customers are confident that they can call us and get those games working. Pinballs are little pieces of history. Most games will never get made again, so part of our mission is to make sure that these games are preserved for future generations to play.
Pinball's a special entertainment device. It's kinetic art. It's really not a toy or a game, it's really a medium. And as such, it's open to endless creative talents by the collaborative efforts of the designers and the engineers who make the things.
Pinball is a very limited resource. There's not many machines out there. And so the people that dedicate lots of time and energy into preserving and upgrading and presenting these games to people, and then also letting people play them freely in their communities, those are our favorite and best customers, because they're the ones that are really, you know, carrying the torch for the pinball community as a whole.
People who own pinball machines are the most interesting people in the world. We have a customer list that includes corporate executives, rock stars, sports figures. They all have game rooms, and they all have pinball machines.
We started investing heavily in these pinball community shows that are happening around the world, primarily in the U.S. now, but we're starting to see them grow in the rest of the world as well. And this is where our favorite customers, the collectors that share, bring their games out to a public location and let everyone in the community come out and play for the weekend. It's a really beautiful thing, and we've been spending lots of time and energy of showing up at these shows as well and trying to also bring new games out for people to enjoy and to get those games in people's hands. And we've seen that grow from just a couple of little shows to now there's over 20 shows throughout the country with thousands of games being represented, with hundreds of thousands of people attending these events. And it's just really rewarding to see that we've had at least a small part in the contributing to the success of that aspect of the pinball community as it's been exploding over the last 10 years.
This show is sponsored by CoinTaker, distributor of brand new, full-size, authentic Stern Pinball, Chicago Gaming, Raw Thrills arcade games, and much more. Also, a full line of dramatic pinball mods, LED flipper kits, speaker lights, custom laser LED toppers, playfield protectors, Bally Williams parts, pinball apparel, and much more. Get the latest releases and glam out your game room with CoinTaker. Everything at your fingertips at CoinTaker.com. Get your game on. We'll be right back.
This Week in Pinball is proud to sponsor and present the TWIPY Pinball Awards. Check out This Week in Pinball for weekly pinball news, exclusive game reveals, interviews, deep dives into new game releases, and exclusive content and stories from everything pinball. This Week in Pinball also does over $1,000 in giveaways each and every month, from partnerships with Pin Stadium, Pin Sound, Comet Pinball, Titan Pinball, Pinball Photos, Silverball Swag, Pinball Life, PinQuest, Hooked on Pinball, P3 Multimorphic, Stern Pinball, Jersey Jack Pinball, and many more. To be automatically entered to win the giveaways each month and to keep This Week in Pinball going, consider supporting TWIP with a small monthly donation on Patreon. Stay tuned for the TWIPY Pinball Awards. We will be starting shortly.
This show is sponsored by CoinTaker, distributor of brand new full-size authentic Stern Pinball, Chicago Gaming, Raw Thrills arcade games, and much more. Also, a full line of dramatic pinball mods, LED flipper kits, speaker lights, custom laser LED toppers, playfield protectors, Bally Williams parts, pinball apparel, and much more. Get the latest releases and glam out your game room with CoinTaker. Everything at your fingertips at CoinTaker.com. Get your game on.
This Week in Pinball is proud to sponsor and present the TWIPY Pinball Awards. Check out This Week in Pinball for weekly pinball news, exclusive game reveals, interviews, deep dives into new game releases, and exclusive content and stories from everything pinball. This Week in Pinball also does over $1,000 in giveaways each and every month, from partnerships with Pin Stadium, Pin Sound, Comet Pinball, Titan Pinball, Pinball Photos, Silverball Swag, Pinball Life, PinQuest, Hooked on Pinball, P3 Multimorphic, Stern Pinball, Jersey Jack Pinball, and many more. To be automatically entered to win the giveaways each month and to keep This Week in Pinball going, consider supporting TWIP with a small monthly donation on Patreon. Stay tuned for the TWIPY Pinball Awards. We will be starting shortly.
So we believe that Marco Specialties is perceived in the market as a partner to our customers. We want to be able to give customers confidence that whatever game they run across, they can call us and get that machine working and beautiful again. 30 years ago, before we got started, if you found a pinball machine, people would say, there's nowhere to get those parts. Just, we don't know what to do. And so now, with Marco around, our customers are confident that they can call us and get those games working. Pinballs are little pieces of history. Most games will never get made again, so part of our mission is to make sure that these games are preserved for future generations to play.
Pinball's a special entertainment device. It's kinetic art. It's really not a toy or a game, it's really a medium. And as such, it's open to endless creative talents by the collaborative efforts of the designers and the engineers who make the things.
Pinball is a very limited resource. There's not many machines out there. And so the people that dedicate lots of time and energy into preserving and upgrading and presenting these games to people, and then also letting people play them freely in their communities, those are our favorite and best customers, because they're the ones that are really, you know, carrying the torch for the pinball community as a whole.
People who own pinball machines are the most interesting people in the world. We have a customer list that includes corporate executives, rock stars, sports figures. They all have game rooms, and they all have pinball machines.
We started investing heavily in these pinball community shows that are happening around the world, primarily in the U.S. now, but we're starting to see them grow in the rest of the world as well. And this is where our favorite customers, the collectors that share, bring their games out to a public location and let everyone in the community come out and play for the weekend. It's a really beautiful thing, and we've been spending lots of time and energy of showing up at these shows as well and trying to also bring new games out for people to enjoy and to get those games in people's hands. And we've seen that grow from just a couple of little shows to now there's over 20 shows throughout the country with thousands of games being represented, with hundreds of thousands of people attending these events. And it's just really rewarding to see that we've had at least a small part in the contributing to the success of that aspect of the pinball community as it's been exploding over the last 10 years.
This show is sponsored by CoinTaker, distributor of brand new full-size authentic Stern Pinball, Chicago Gaming, Raw Thrills arcade games, and much more. Also, a full line of dramatic pinball mods, LED flipper kits, speaker lights, custom laser LED toppers, playfield protectors, Bally Williams parts, pinball apparel, and much more. Get the latest releases and glam out your game room with CoinTaker. Everything at your fingertips at CoinTaker.com. Get your game on.
This Week in Pinball is proud to sponsor and present the TWIPY Pinball Awards. Check out This Week in Pinball for weekly pinball news, exclusive game reveals, interviews, deep dives into new game releases, and exclusive content and stories from everything pinball. This Week in Pinball also does over $1,000 in giveaways each and every month from partnerships with Pin Stadium, Pin Sound, Comet Pinball, Titan Pinball, Pinball Photos, Silverball Swag, Pinball Life, PinQuest, Hooked on Pinball, P3 Multimorphic, Stern Pinball, Jersey Jack Pinball, and many more. To be automatically entered to win the giveaways each month and to keep This Week in Pinball going, consider supporting TWIP with a small monthly donation on Patreon. Stay tuned for the TWIPY Pinball Awards. We will be starting shortly.
This show is sponsored by CoinTaker, distributor of brand new, full-size, authentic Stern Pinball, Chicago Gaming, Raw Thrills arcade games, and much more. Also, a full line of dramatic pinball mods, LED flipper kits, speaker lights, custom laser LED toppers, playfield protectors, Bally Williams parts, pinball apparel, and much more. Get the latest releases and glam out your game room with CoinTaker. Everything at your fingertips at CoinTaker.com. Get your game on.
This Week in Pinball is proud to sponsor and present the TWIPY Pinball Awards. Check out This Week in Pinball for weekly pinball news, exclusive game reveals, interviews, deep dives into new game releases, and exclusive content and stories from everything pinball. This Week in Pinball also does over $1,000 in giveaways each and every month from partnerships with Pin Stadium, Pin Sound, Comet Pinball, Titan Pinball, Pinball Photos, Silverball Swag, Pinball Life, PinQuest, Hooked on Pinball, P3 Multimorphic, Stern Pinball, Jersey Jack Pinball, and many more. To be automatically entered to win the giveaways each month and to keep This Week in Pinball going, consider supporting TWIP with a small monthly donation on Patreon. Stay tuned for the TWIPY Pinball Awards. We will be starting shortly.
So we believe that Marco Specialties is perceived in the market as a partner to our customers. We want to be able to give customers confidence that whatever game they run across, they can call us and get that machine working and beautiful again. 30 years ago, before we got started, if you found a pinball machine, people would say, there's nowhere to get those parts. We don't know what to do. And so now, with Marco around, our customers are confident that they can call us and get those games working. Pinballs are little pieces of history. Most games will never get made again. So part of our mission is to make sure that these games are preserved for future generations to play.
Pinball's a special entertainment device. It's kinetic art. It's really not a toy or a game. It's really a medium. And as such, it's open to endless creative talents by the collaborative efforts of the designers and the engineers who make the things.
Pinball is a very limited resource. There's not many machines out there. And so the people that dedicate lots of time and energy into preserving and upgrading and presenting these games to people, and then also letting people play them freely in their communities, those are our favorite and best customers, because they're the ones that are really, you know, carrying the torch for the pinball community as a whole.
People who own pinball machines are the most interesting people in the world. We have a customer list that includes corporate executives, rock stars, sports figures. They all have game rooms, and they all have pinball machines.
We started investing heavily in these pinball community shows that are happening around the world, primarily in the U.S. now, but we're starting to see them grow in the rest of the world as well. And this is where our favorite customers, the collectors that share, bring their games out to a public location and let everyone in the community come out and play for the weekend. It's a really beautiful thing, and we've been spending lots of time and energy of showing up at these shows as well and trying to also bring new games out for people to enjoy and to get those games in people's hands. And we've seen that grow from just a couple of little shows to now there's over 20 shows throughout the country with thousands of games being represented, with hundreds of thousands of people attending these events. And it's just really rewarding to see that we've had at least a small part in the contributing to the success of that aspect of the pinball community as it's been exploding over the last 10 years.
Ladies and gentlemen, This Week in Pinball presents a Marco Specialties production. Welcome to the third annual TWIPY Awards, a celebration of pinball excellence. Introducing your hosts, Imoto Arcade and Cary Hardy.
What's up, guys, and welcome to the third annual TWIPY Awards. Here we are. Digitally. It sucks that we can't be at TPF in one room together, but we're still glad that we can all be here in this format to celebrate pinball together.
We can actually be at TPF right now. Watch this, Cary. We're at TPF! Oh. Hello, everybody out in the chat room. Thank you so much for joining us. I'm glad we're all practicing social distancing, yet we can still be here together tonight to celebrate pinball. We want to thank our sponsors, This Week in Pinball, Marco Specialties, Pinball Star, Silver Ball Slag. Gosh, I can't say that word. Silver Ball Swag. Consider changing your name for Imoto. I'd appreciate that. Thank you. And Coin Taker. You guys are awesome and help make all this happen. So thank you so much. So Cary, why don't we tell the audience what the TWIPYs are all about?
So the TWIPYs are celebrating everything pinball, especially for the year 2019. So a lot of games were brought out and a lot of people did a lot of things, and it's this time where we celebrate all those people that contributed to this hobby. So we have an online committee, secure voting process that people vote. You voted for these people. This is People's Choice Awards, guys. And we have an online committee that securely takes these votes, tallies them all together, and now here we are to show you who was the victor in all of those categories.
And now let's just get on with the show. Our first category is Best Music and Sound Effects, and presenting this is Scott DeNisi, Pinball Community's favorite designer.
Best Music and Sound Effects.
I didn't see you there. And the nominees for Best Music and Sound Effects are...
Black Knight, Sword of Rage by Stern Pinball. Jurassic Park by Stern Pinball. Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory by Jersey Jack Pinball.
And the winner is...
Black Knight, Sword of Rage by Stern Pinball.
Black Knight, baby, best sound and music. I didn't make the music, but I'd like to make a special shout out to Steve Ritchie for voice talent. I'd like to also shout out Jerry Thompson, Scott Ian, Brendan Small, and Ken Hale for all their work on the music. We also had some extra special speech talent for Brendan Small, Pearl Adey, Mike Kizavat, and Tom Kizavat for all their voices of the different skeletons in the game. Working on this game was a ton of fun. And the high energy soundtrack is just, it's too fun not to play along with it. So I had an awesome time. Now let's send it over to you, Steve.
Hey, pinball fans, Steve Ritchie here. Black Knight Sword of Rage won a TWIPY Award for Best Music and Sound Effects. How about that? We gratefully accept the award, and I would like to thank Scott Ian and Brendan Small for the outrageous music and sound effects. I would also like to thank Ken Hale, Jerry Thompson, and most of all, Tim Sexton, who hammered the whole thing together into a rich, powerful pinball experience. It's awesome! Thanks again to everyone, and please stay safe.
Oh, hey. Got Ian here, playing the Black Knight Sword of Rage machine, and hey man. So I guess I won Best Soundtrack at the TWIPYS Awards. Well, thank you very much for that, because it is the best soundtrack. It kicks ass. Thank you. Thanks, everyone. Cheers. Stern Pinball rules.
Congrats to Scott, Ian, and the Stern team for some badass music and some really good sound effects. If I had long enough hair, I would be rocking out, headbanging while I play that game. That is how awesome that soundtrack is. So I think without further ado, we're going to go ahead and go right into our next category, and we're going to bring in none other than Lauren Gray from Backbox Pinball Podcast.
Favorite homebrew pinball machine.
Hey everybody, thank you so much for letting me be a part of this event. Thanks to Jeff, thanks to Imoto and Cary. I am so excited to be a presenter here at the 2020 TWIPYs. Okay, when they told me what category I was presenting, I was like, yes, because all pinheads can be in this category. Because at one point in your pinhead life, you have said, why did they put that there? Or if I designed a pinball machine, I would do it like this. And the people in this category just said, hold my beer. The nominees for Best Homebrew Pinball Machine are
Castlevania by Justin Kalinowski. Dead Flip by Jack Danger. Baseballs, The Pin by Wolf Marsh. And the winner is Dead Flip by Jack Danger.
Wow, thank you again for voting for me for favorite homebrew. That's insane. Collecting this TWIPY isn't for me, this is for the entire homebrew community, because our game was built with everyone. So a lot of people had input on how to design this, and I built it for you so that you too can learn how to build a pinball machine. And it's been a journey, it's been a lot of hair pulling, but it's been fun. And we have a fully functioning game now. But again, this is all thanks to you. So many of you had your hands in this game. Even from the get-go, when we were first sketching stuff down, people are like, well, throw a pump off or there, like, what if there was a spinner here to try the, like, you all built this. You just used my hands to put it together. So again, thank you all so much, and a big shout out to everyone else who has made amazing homebrew machines out there. There's too many to list, and there's more popping up every single day, so please keep building, and this trophy, I'm gonna scratch my name out and just put a big smiley face. Thank you. I love you guys. Thank you so much.
Congratulations, Jackie Boy, for winning Best Homebrew Pinball Machine. And really, I don't know about you, Cary, but I think Jack should cut that trophy into like a million different pieces and then send them to all of his audience in his stream, because he streamed his entire process, is streaming his entire process, and we're all kind of involved in that. So we all kind of just won collectively Best Homebrew Pinball Machine. Am I right?
It's definitely good to be able to see the entire process from start to finish. And it's not even finished yet, but we get to see all the intricacies and difficulty behind creating a pinball machine.
It's very, very intimidating. I will not be doing it soon. But kudos to all you guys out there that do make your own pinball machines. You're awesome. So let's continue with the show, because we got a lot of categories to go. And our next category is actually going to be Best Toys and Gimmicks. Who's presenting, Cary?
The, The person, or people, I should say, that are going to be presenting this award are none other than the Poor Man's Podcast people, Drew and Ian. So it's a good thing that we're doing it digitally. That way we don't have to worry about any kind of liability issues or them tripping over stuff or throwing up on the podium or anything like that. So thankfully, we're doing it this way this year for that good reason right there. So Drew and Ian, take it away.
Best toys and gimmicks.
Hi guys, I'm Ian.
Hey guys, I'm Drew.
And we are the Poor Man's Pinball Podcast.
We talk about pinball news, sometimes we get a little drunk, and we tell great dad jokes like this gem. And the award for best neckwear of the year goes to... It's a tie.
Feels good, doesn't it?
They get better all the time.
All right, so it's our honor and privilege to be the presenters. To be the presenters of
Toys and Gimmicks.
Best Toys and Gimmicks. Thank you, Drew.
No problem.
And well, without further ado, these are your nominees.
Black Knight, Sword of Rage by Stern Pinball.
Magnuson, yeah!
This game is the only Black Knight where you actually fight the Black Knight.
Fight me!
Jurassic Park by Stern Pinball.
All eating T-Rex, and just to make a much more fun game. We have four ramps total, a kinetic raptor toy, the first ever horizontal helicopter spinner, a helical ramp that feeds an upper flipper, which is a first in pinball.
Just crying at how beautiful it is.
Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory by Jersey Jack Pinball.
You should open your mouth a little wider when you speak.
Stop, don't, come back.
There it goes. So you get nothing. You lose. Good day, sir.
And the winner is...
Jurassic Park by Stern Pinball.
Hey, this is Mike Vindicor from Stern Pinball. I'm sorry that the rest of the team couldn't be here today, but as a proud member of the Jurassic Park team, thank you all so much for voting for the best toys and gimmicks for Jurassic Park. We really had a lot of fun making it. It was a lot of hard work, but it was very rewarding and a lot of fun in the end. We're very proud of the game, and we're really glad that everybody loves it so much. Thank you again for all your support. And we will be making more games for you in the future.
Congrats to Mike Vindicor and team for the very nice toy inside Jurassic Park. Watching that T-Rex munch around on that pinball never gets old. And what else doesn't get old? Location pinball. And that's going to be our next category. So what would you consider locations? Well, that is anywhere where you typically have to pay to play. So a lot of places, even in my Dallas area, it's like $10 to get in and you have a plethora of pinball machines to play on. Or you go to another location, a bar, and it's play per game. That's what it is. So anywhere you go publicly and you play pinball, that is where this is going to
fall. Arcade! And presenting this awesome category, one of my favorite categories, and one of my favorite presenters, are none other than my Marco Specialties crew, Crystal Gemnick and Kyle Spiteri. Take it away, guys.
Favorite pinball location.
Hey, everybody. Crystal and I were supposed to present this award together, but Marco Specialties has us working separate shifts to keep our facilities clean, safe, and fully operational.
This is my favorite coworker.
It's like a good boner noise. Okay. Hey everybody, Crystal and I were supposed to start over. Can you see that the skate light is out? Can you see that this one's out right here? Everyone's gonna notice that. Hey everyone, Crystal and I were going to present this award together, But Marco Specialties has us working separate shifts to keep our facilities clean, safe, and fully operational.
Just like our favorite pinball locations. We're excited to present the nominees for Favorite Pinball Location.
Logan Arcade in Chicago, Illinois. The Pinball Palace in Brunswick, Georgia. Titletown Pinball in De Pere, Wisconsin.
And the winner is...
Logan Arcade in Chicago, Illinois.
Congratulations, Logan Arcade, for winning Best Pinball Location. I personally love Logan Arcade. It's definitely in my top five. Cary, have you ever been there?
I've never been there, but next time I go to Chicago, I will make an appointment to make that happen.
Yeah. How about right now? Bam!
Oh!
Logan Arcade. Yeah. Except we can't play any games right now. So we're just going to move on to our next category, which is favorite pinball publication, writer, or article. Now, this category is anything written with the subject of pinball. You are up to be nominated.
Favorite pinball publication, writer, or article. Coin Op Carnival. Pinball Magazine's newsletters. Skillshot, Seattle's pinball zine. And the winner is Pinball Magazine's newsletters.
Okay, I'm really not good with doing these type of videos, but hi, my name is Jonathan. I'm the editor of Pinball Magazine. And if you're watching this video, that means that I apparently won my second TWIPY for Best Pinball Publication. Now, normally I would say thank you very much. In this case, I would say, you stupid idiots, you should have voted for Coin Op Carnival. So why didn't you? Go get this publication because it really deserves to win the TWIPY this year. Now for next year, however, Pinball Magazine number 6 is being in the works, and really I am working on it right now, so I'll be happy to collect my TWIPY for 2020 next year, this time around. So, but congrats to Nick and Ryan for Coin Op Carnival because they really deserve to win. If I won, I'll be handing over my TWIPY to them. So, thank you, bye bye.
Congrats, Jonathan, for Best Pinball Publication. And we're going to move on to our next category, which is Best Theme, presented by none other than Flipping Out Pinballs, Zach Minnie, and Eclectic Gamers Podcast, Dennis Kreisel.
Best Theme.
Hey, Dennis, we get the honor of presenting the Best Pinball Theme of 2019. And, buddy, they can't all be The Hobbit. Or Popeye.
Oh, jeez. This was a disaster to get selected for. Oh, but you know, Zach, what I always say. You don't play the playfield, you play the theme.
Oh, well, I guess. Is it a typical, atypical layout? How's that work?
Symmetrical versus asymmetrical.
Oh, yeah, symmetrical polynomial. Well, it's funny you should mention themes, Dennis, because the best themes to me are the ones that you and I share, and that is, wait for it, friendship and love.
Oh my, just move on.
Yeah. Just move on. All right. And the nominees are
Elvira's House of Horrors by Stern Pinball, Jurassic Park by Stern Pinball. Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory by Jersey Jack Pinball.
And the winner is...
Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory by Jersey Jack Pinball.
Thank you. On behalf of everybody from Jersey Jack Pinball, everybody that works for the company, we want to thank you all that voted for us for the best theme. We really love Willy Wonka, and we love the fact that everybody enjoys the game so much. So thank you again to everybody. It's an honor.
Come with me, and we'll be in a world of pure imagination.
Let's try to keep this going, Imoto.
All right, fine. So congratulations, Willy Wonka team, for that awesome win. I love that theme. The next category is now favorite competitive pinball player, and presenting this award is Mike TV. He's this big. Well, Paris Themon is the actual actor, and here he is now.
Favorite competitive pinball player.
Hey everybody, how you doing? I'm Paris Themon. And a long time ago, I played Mike TV in Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory. And I'm here with my favorite pinball machine by Jersey Jacks. I'm biased, but it's an awesome machine. And I'm here to announce the following category. For favorite competitive pinball player, the nominees are...
Bowen Cairns. Jack Danger. Keith Elwin.
And the winner is... Keith Elwin. Congratulations to him, and keep playing pinball.
Hi, Keith Elwin here, as you can tell by my Loser Kid Pinball Podcast hat and my Stern Pinball t-shirt. Still don't believe me? Check out my 5 Pinbird trophies. I just want to thank everybody for voting for me for favorite competitive pinball player, but I'd like to put it on the record that I voted for Johannes. Thanks, everybody.
Congratulations, Keith, for that award. I mean, I thought you were sexy before, but I think you've turned it up a notch. I'm like, did you get a tan? Is that what I'm seeing there? So, what's our next category, Imoto?
Our next category is favorite pinball convention. And last year, this presenter, Jersey Jack, ripped his shirt off to tell us who the winner was. So let's see what he does this year.
Favorite pinball convention.
Yes, it is Jersey Jack coming to you from the beautiful Jersey Shore. The ocean is like an old man trying to return soup at a deli. And the nominees are...
Pinball Expo. Replay Effects. Texas Pinball Festival.
And the winner is...
Texas Pinball Festival.
Guys and gals, we're really excited to be here this evening and accepting this award on behalf of the Texas Pinball Festival. And I think back to 20 years ago now when 9 of us were together at an auction going, oh my God, we've got to save pinball. What do? Is anybody even going to show up if we put our games together? And we got through that first show and it's just kept going. And, you know, here we are 20 years later. And, you know, the important thing is it's not those 9 guys anymore. It's all of you that come to our show. It's all of you that volunteer. And we share this with you. We really appreciate this award and everything that you do for us.
We appreciate all the love and support. Y'all have been awesome. We're working through it. 2021 is going to be great. So thank you, everyone, for your love and support. We appreciate it so much.
Thank you.
Bye.
That's what I'm talking about, Texas. Keep reeling in all those TWIPY awards. What's going to be our next category, Imoto?
Our next category is Best Theme Integration, not to be confused with Best Theme. Theme integration means you don't necessarily have the coolest theme, but it's how you utilize it into your design. And presenting that category is Stephen Young from Pinball Undesirables, someone who is always allowed to stream at our Marco Specialties booth.
Best theme integration.
Theme integration. It's making sure that all of the elements of the game are influenced by that game's theme. Do it right and you create that cliche world under glass. Our nominees for Best Theme Integration of the Year are
Elvira's House of Horrors by Stern Pinball.
Jurassic Park by Stern Pinball. Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory by Jersey Jack Pinball.
And the TWIPY goes to
Jurassic Park by Stern Pinball.
When the team came up with the concept of having a new story set in the Jurassic Park universe, being about the dinosaurs and trying to escape the park, I really thought it was a great direction because I wanted to go back to the world of Jurassic Park that I kind of grew up watching along with most of us. And the story that the team, Keith in particular, wrote, I thought was just absolutely fantastic and really fit pinball. You know, you play in the game and you really do feel like you're in that park, you're trying to trap these dinosaurs, and it really adds a lot of fun and immersion into the Jurassic Park world. On behalf of Stern and the Jurassic Park team, thank you all for your support and for your votes.
Congratulations to Keith Elwin and team for Jurassic Park on Best Theme Integration. Speaking of integration, what better way to integrate pinball into society than a website? And our next category is going to be Best Pinball Website.
And presenting that category is my big brother from another mother, Jack Danger.
Favorite Pinball Website.
And the nominees for Favorite Pinball Website are... Here we go. And the nominees for Favorite Pinball Website are... And the nominees for Favorite Pinball Website are...
Match Play Events. Pinside. This Week in Pinball.
And the winner is...
Pinside.
What? Marco Specialties didn't win Best Website? Oh, come on. I'm just kidding. We all know that Pinside is number one. Well deserved, y'all. Let's move on to our next category, which is Best Animations and Display, and presenting that category is Bare Naked Ladies.
What? Hell yeah, that's what... No, this is on YouTube. This will, like, demonetize me so fast it would not be good.
Cary, Ed Robertson from the band Bare Naked Ladies.
Okay, yeah, that's actually better.
All right, let's get on with it.
Best Animations and Display.
Well, hello, pinball fans. My name is Ed Robertson. I play in a band called Bare Naked Ladies. I eat, sleep, and breathe pinball. I hope you're enjoying this year's TWIPY Awards. I am here to say hello to you, to wish you well, and hope you're not spreading an ungodly virus just by enjoying pinball. And I'm here to present the award for Best Animations and Display. And the nominees are...
Black Knight, Sword of Rage by Stern Pinball. Animations by Joshua Clay and Zach Stark. Jurassic Park by Stern Pinball. Animations by Chuck Ernst and team. Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory by Jersey Jack Pinball. Animations by Jean-Paul DeWitt.
And the winner of this year's TWIPY Award for Best Animations and Display, you guessed it, it's Big Game. No, it is... It is Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory by Jersey Jack Pinball. Congratulations.
Thank you. Thank you for voting on Wonka for Best Animations in Pinball. Wow. Three times in a row. First, Dial In, then Pirates of the Caribbean, this year Wonka. Wow. Honestly, I had expected Jurassic Park to win. Animations were great. Competition was good. But can't thank you enough. That's why I hired all these guys over there. Saves me some time. Also need to thank Mark Molitor. He's animator in the Chicago office of Jersey Jack Pinball. He started doing Wonka, learning the stuff in our game. And Olaf Cremie, he's from Amsterdam. He animated all the Oompa Loompas. So thanks to them as well, on behalf of the Jersey Jack Pinball team. Working hard on the next game, hopefully my fourth, JP, for the win, we'll see. Hope to see you next year, stay healthy, these are bizarre times. I wish the show was live again, but because last year in Texas was great. Unfortunately, the events this year are not so good. So hopefully next year we can see each other again on many pinball shows. Till next time, thanks.
Congratulations, Jean-Paul, for Best Animations Display with your Willy Wonka machine. Moving on to our next category, and that's going to be Rookie of the Year. Now, this deserves a little bit of explanation, because Rookie of the Year falls in line to those of us have, basically, this is their first time doing something in the pinball industry for the year 2019, whether it be a first-time distributor, first-time podcaster, first-time designer, the list goes on and on. If this is something new for this individual in the year 2019, then that throws you into the category of Rookie of the Year. Now, the presenter we have for this is none other than Jerry Stellenberg, who just recently announced his new game for his multimorphic platform, Heist.
Heist! It looks awesome.
Rookie of the Year.
These are the people that bring fresh ideas and help move the industry forward. And the nominees are...
Jack Danger for Homebrew Designer. Tim Sexton for Lead Coder on Black Knight, Sword of Rage. Zach and Nicole Mini for distribution with Flippin' Out Pinball.
And the winner is...
Tim Sexton for Lead Coder on Black Knight, Sword of Rage.
All right, I know I look like a sports broadcaster right now, and it's not just that I miss sports, it's that I miss you, everyone, in the pinball community in these tough times we're living through, but I'd really like to say thank you. This is the best microphone I have, so I'm going to wear this and do it. Thank you everyone who nominated me and voted for me for Rookie of the Year this year. For the TWIPY Awards, it's awesome. I'm very excited to receive it. Ever since I got involved in this hobby, I have always wanted to make sure I could get the most people the most excited about pinball. And I know that we could keep this thing going. There's so much passion and so much enthusiasm in the hobby that this thing's going to keep going for a really long time. Pinball's been around for a long time, and it's just going to stay great. It's going to be awesome. And I'd really like to thank Jeff Patterson, who runs thisweekinpinball.com. I'd like to thank the whole TWIPY committee for all their work they did and going through all the nominations and votes and everything like that. And I'd love to thank the pinball community just in general for their support, for everything everyone's done to support each other during these times. These fundraisers to help people out of work for, you know, losing their jobs because these pinball places have temporarily gone out of business. Hopefully they'll all bounce back very soon and we'll have some great times together again. But in the meantime, I would just want to make sure everyone does their part. Limit your contact, be aware of the social distancing, wash your hands, practice good hygiene, and together we'll all get through this and we'll be flipping together once again. So thank you very much.
Congratulations, Tim Sexton, for winning Rookie of the Year. We were all rooting for you. I mean, I was personally rooting for you. I'm glad you won. Let's move on to the next category, which is favorite pinball competition or tournament.
And the presenter for this award is none other than the man that brought us the Pinbot series, as well as the man that is currently working with Deep Root on his next title, Barry Owsler.
Favorite pinball tournament competition.
Hi, I'm Barry Owsler. Here are the nominees for the favorite pinball tournament / competition.
IFPA Pinball Olympics 2019 in Fulda, Germany. Pinburg. Texas Wizards Tournament.
How come my home strip pinball tournament wasn't in this list? And the winner is
Pinburg.
Congrats, Pinburg, on the award for favorite pinball tournament. And we're moving on to the next category, which is going to be best callouts. Yeah, baby, you want some fries with that shake?
No, Cary, not cat calls. Best callouts.
And oh, yeah.
Presenting this award is Dr. Pin from the Super Awesome Pinball Show and Mrs. Pin from Mrs. Pin Pinball Podcast. Can you guys just do a podcast together? The Dr. and Mrs. Pin Pinball Show? No? All right, here's the video.
Best callouts.
Hey everyone, it's the Pins, and we're super excited to be here with you tonight celebrating all things pinball.
You know, this is an awesome way to do the TWIPYs this year. It's like a virtual playdate with thousands of our closest pinball friends.
And we're here to present one of the coolest parts of any pinball machine, best pinball callout.
Ooh, like when I call out to you and let you know I've taken your GC again?
Yeah, I don't remember that ever happening. No, babe, it's when you do something really good or really bad, or someone just comes on randomly and says something from the machine, like, why did Nedry do this?
Oh, like Wonka, my favorite one. Augustus, save some room for later. Or I also love Black Knight when Steve Ritchie comes on and verbally abuses you if you miss your shot.
That's exactly right. Yeah, why don't we check out all of the awesome nominees.
Black Knight, Sword of Rage by Stern Pinball.
All I need is a spark.
What sounds have you got? None. Let me end your wretched life.
Excellent. An extra ball.
Elvira's House of Horrors by Stern Pinball.
Some might say two heads are better than one, but this haunt proves otherwise. Let's put our heads together and get this anatomical aberration back where he belongs, on film.
One zombie in a tall glass. Super jackpot.
Jurassic Park by Stun Pinball.
It's a Unix system! You know this!
I hate this hacker crap!
Shoot the left ramp!
And the winner is... Elvira's House of Horrors by Stun Pinball.
Hi everyone, Tim Kitzer here, aka Mr. Boom Shakalaka from NBA Jam, NFL Blitz, a whole bunch of other video games, but more importantly, the voice of pinball games from the early days at Williams Valley Midway, but now back with Stern Pinball. Stern Pinball is killing it! They're on fire! And I just found out that we received a TWIPY award for best call-out for Elvira's House of Horrors! I play Elvira's sidekick for the third time. I did the first game, the original Elvira, then Scared Stiff, and now the House of Horrors. And I don't know if my character has a name. I'll call him Fred. So anyway, I'm Fred, and I also do all the talking heads, the ghosts, the chowderhead that says, "Hey, watch out, you take another shot at me like that, I'll drop you like a rock lobster, and you are going down, 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 my friend." And I want to thank the Dream Team, the Legends, the Icons, Lyman Sheets, Greg Ferris, Dennis Nordman, and on sound, Jerry Thompson. And of course, Cassandra Peterson, the ageless, the voluptuous Elvira. And I'm sorry I can't be there tonight, Elvira, but you know, I never go out before dark. And right now, I'm getting nailed in the coffin big time. You know what I always say, when the coffins are rocking, don't come a-mocking. I don't have to tell you twice. Thank you, everyone. What a great award. What a great time to be back in the pinball business while the arcades are surging. We really appreciate this, and we'll see you at the arcade soon.
Congratulations to Stern Pinball and their team for Elvira House of Horrors, and to Cassandra Peterson, who actually did her own call-outs and put on her Elvira Mistress of the Dark costume and went over to Stern and recorded all the video assets for the game. That's just absolutely amazing. So very well-deserved award.
Yes, indeed.
Our next category is now going to be favorite pinball YouTube channel. And who's presenting this category today?
The people we have presenting for best YouTube pinball channel, or pinball YouTube channel, whichever way you want to say it, is going to be the two guys from American Pinball, Josh Kugler and Joe Schober.
Favorite pinball YouTube channel.
I'm Josh Kugler from American Pinball, and like many of you, I'm sheltered at home, and I hope all of you are staying safe. Like many of you, I'm fortunate enough to have a few of these to keep me company, but I'll be spending most of my time over the next few weeks with this guy. One thing we are all fortunate for is the wide range of pinball channels on YouTube, and whether they're there to entertain, to inform, to educate, or all of the above, they do it with a passion for pinball. And the nice thing is, you can enjoy them all even while sheltered at home. And the nominees for favorite pinball YouTube channel are...
Papa Pinball. Straight down the middle, a pinball show.
I miss you, Greg.
TNT Amusements.
You don't have to go home, but you can't stay here.
And the winner is...
Papa Pinball.
Hey, I'm Bowen. We're here in Salem, Massachusetts to play some Alice Cooper's... Oh, no, I'm sorry. We're just here to accept the award for favorite YouTube channel for Papa Pinball. I appreciate all of the support that I've had on Patreon over the years, as well as people who come up to me and ask, just let me know that the series of tutorial videos have helped them learn to play pinball. Also, big thanks to James Emanuel, Doug Polka, and the rest of the folks who are behind the Papa TV Live series that is on just about every week, broadcasting new games from Papa headquarters that will be useful for more gameplay videos and preparation for Pinburg and replay effects as well. So thank you so much for supporting this channel and for supporting pinball. Let's all keep in touch with each other over the next few months.
What? What's this? I didn't win.
Oh, you found somebody else that makes better videos than we did, yeah? You creeps! Well, you know, I... Hours editing. Who did you give the award to anyway? Pinball Buckle.
Well, I'm sorry. Just like last year, I made my own award up. Look, let me show it to you. Wallace was in charge of the award making. It's my annual TWIT award. Now, it was 2019, but somebody thought it was supposed to be 2020, so they crossed out and made it 2019 again. There it is. And mine comes with full animation, see? And I am going to treasure this award. Aren't I? Drop it.
Congrats, Papa Pinball, for winning Favorite Pinball YouTube Channel.
You know, that's how I actually learned how to play pinball, just watching the Papa tutorials and Bowen Curran tutorials, cramming all these rules into my mind.
Is it Curran's or Karen's?
Bowen Curran's. So, Cary, what's the next category?
Our next category is going to be Best Pinball Mod of the Year 2019.
And mod means modification to your pinball machine that is not factory standard. And the nominees are...
Favorite Pinball Mod of 2019. Amber Jurassic Park Shooter Rod by Stern Pinball. Chess Mod for JJP Pirates by the Pinball Mod Company. Wonka Factory Mod by the Mod Couple. And the winner is...
Amber Jurassic Park Shooter Rod by Stern Pinball.
Wow, that's amazing. That is my favorite rod of 2019. Lights up and everything.
I'm not going to touch that.
Speaking of lights, our next category is Best Light Show.
And none other than Jeff Patterson from This Week in Pinball will be giving us the nominations for Best Light Show.
Best Light Show.
Hey everybody, it's Jeff from This Week in Pinball. Hope you're enjoying the show. I'm here to present Best Light Show. Last year it was Pirates of the Caribbean. And the year before that it was Total Nuclear Annihilation. And the nominees for this year are...
Black Knight, Sword of Rage by Stern Pinball. Jurassic Park by Stern Pinball. Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory by Jesse Jack Pinball.
And the winner is...
Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory by Jesse Jack Pinball.
On behalf of everybody in the company, we want to say thank you for this award, Best Light Show. Our games are all amazing. Willy Wonka is an amazing game. And it all started with Wizard of Oz. So we have people in the company that really love what they do. And we do it all for you, the players and the people that vote for us. Thank you very much.
Congratulations, JJP, for winning Best Light Show with your Willy Wonka machine. And on to our next category, which is going to be... Whoa, nice shades you got there, Imoto.
Oh yeah, you like these? They're my pin shades. They help keep the glare off the games and those blaring light shows from my sensitive little eyes. Protects them.
So what's our next category?
Moving on to the next category. Is favorite...
Streamer? Favorite pinball streamer?
So the next category is favorite pinball streamer, and to present this award is someone who can't smash a trophy this year, none other than Christopher Franchi.
Favorite pinball streamer.
Hello everybody, this is Christopher Franchi, and I'm here at Studio La France, where all the art magic happens, and I'm here to introduce you to the nominees for favorite pinball streamer. Thank God for pinball streaming, because otherwise I'd be sitting around in my underwear and a webcam chat with your sister. Ew. Here's the nominees.
Dead Flip.
All right. It's going up the main chute. Oh, it's coming down. Oh, dude. Okay, you got it. Okay, you're going to do better than me. Let's see. So, where were you born? And what was life like?
Me now. I am from Chicago, Illinois.
From Chicago?
And raised. Okay. And I suck at pinball.
Flipping out pinball.
Friends are here for Monday night.
And I pinball tonight to my right, Ryan White, Vice President of Sales at Chicago Gaming Company.
Oh, yeah.
And to his right, Mr. Steve Beattie. But we got some bits.
Joe Fox is here.
What's up, man?
What's up, Joe?
Papa TV.
Pinburg 2019.
We have behind us a crowd of hundreds of pinball players who have been here all weekend flipping for the glory.
You can see the games waiting to be played.
Oh, my God!
And the winner is Dead Flip.
Favorite frickin' pinball streamer for 3 years in a row. This is the big one. This is the award that means the most to me. This is what we've won for 2 years in a row, and I can't thank you enough for voting for us again. This is awesome. I do this for you. I do all this crazy crap, building machines, buying new gear, setting up rigs, traveling places. I do this for you guys, and it's reciprocated with you being in chat every day and just saying how much you appreciate what's going on, and then do this, stuff like this, voting for me for the TWIPYs. I honestly, it warms my heart, and I can't thank you enough for, you know, just helping me help you is what's happening. I love you guys so much. Thank you from the bottom of my heart. This is the award, 3 years running. Thank you. That other TWIPY's gonna look great next to these two little babies. I love you. Thank you.
International pinball sensation won not one, not two, but 3 years in a row. Congratulations, Jack. Our next category is Favorite Pinball League. And let me take a moment to remind you guys that this is People's Choice Award. So if you don't see your league listed on the nominees, it's probably because you guys didn't go out and vote, or there wasn't enough of you to go out and vote. So remember, you guys voted. These are the winners you guys picked. So, Cary, who's presenting?
The presenter for this award is none other than the designer for Pirates of the Caribbean with Jersey Jack Pinballs, Eric Minier.
Favorite Pinball League.
Thanks, guys. Hey, everyone. Welcome to the third annual TWIPY Awards, and thanks for having me back as a presenter. This is pretty cool. I'm filming from my home in Chicago, Illinois, where I am sheltering in place with 5 or so JJP games and a couple others. And I'm here to present the award for the Best Pinball League, while representing the Best Pinball League, in my opinion, the Chicago Pinball Authority. So, your nominees are...
Bells and Chimes in San Antonio, Texas. New England Pinball League. Titletown Pinball in De Pere, Wisconsin.
And congratulations to the winning league.
Bells and Chimes in San Antonio, Texas.
Another Texas resident takes home a TWIPY award. Congratulations, Bells and Chimes, for winning. And our next category is going to be Best Rules, but Imoto, why are you so excited about this
because
particular category?
Because we got the best presenter for this. I'm so excited. It's our celebrity presenter. Check it out.
Best Rules.
Hey there, all you pinball fans. It is Sean Astin here, actor, otherwise known as Samwise Gamgee from The Lord of the Rings, Bob Newby from Stranger Things, and pinball aficionado. There's actually also Mikey from the Goonies pinball game that I played in Vegas. Lost a lot of money. I don't know about that. But anyhow, what can I say? Congratulations on the award show. I would like to present the next category. Ladies and gentlemen, the next category is Best Rules. Best Rules. The nominees are
Black Knight, Sword of Rage by Stern Pinball. Rules by Tim Sexton and team. No
mercy. You're like, well, it is the Black Knight. He doesn't want me to win. He wants me to lose. And it's my job to figure out how to advance past him to win the game.
Empty your pockets.
Jurassic Park by Stern Pinball. Rules by Keith Elwin and team.
This entire game was designed around the truck target here, which toggles back and forth. When I came up with this mech, I knew exactly what I wanted to do. Have it navigate the island to get the different paddocks.
Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory by Jersey Jack Pinball. Rules by Joe Katz and team.
We're considering that the factory tour. So what you'll want to do is qualify different sections of that line and play those modes, get those awards, with the objective of trying to play them all.
And the winner is
Jurassic Park by Stern Pinball. Rules by Keith Elwin and team.
Jurassic Park. Woo! Go Jurassic Park. It's just an honor to be nominated.
One of the things that constantly amazes me about Keith Elwin, the lead designer of Jurassic Park and Iron Maiden before that, was not only does he design these great playfields, but he designs the whole rule set too. The two games that he's made have been my favorites and the ones that I keep coming back to long after the games are finished. Keith has designed my favorite rule sets since I've been a Stern employee, and I'm not just saying that because he puts a skill shot in his game named after me that I come up with in each one of his games, and he bought me this fancy suit for this award ceremony. Thank you all for voting for this award. Thank you for your support of Stern Pinball. On behalf of the rest of the Jurassic Park team and the entire company, we thank you and for your support and look forward to bringing you more fun games in the future.
Congratulations, Keith Elwin and team, for the super refreshing rules on Jurassic Park. And Cary, is that not the coolest thing that we actually got Sean Astin to present an award?
Hell yeah, I'm glad that Jeff was able to get him to hop on board this train, and we got a nice celebrity in here. We got all, I mean, he's played so many roles, it's kind of hard to pinpoint which one I want to call out. We can go Sam all the way back to the Goonies. I think of Encino Man. I mean, I think of all kinds of stuff that he's been in, but it's really cool to have him in here, though.
Definitely. And he says he's looking forward to a Goonies machine, so you never know what that means.
Well, someone made one, but it's just not all over the world type of thing, so I'm up for it. But speaking up, like toppers, which is going to be our next category, and introducing the nominees for this category for favorite topper of 2019 is Josh and Scott from Loser Kid Pinball Podcast.
Favorite pinball topper of 2019.
Thanks for tuning in to the 2019 TWIPYs. I am Josh Roop, along with my co-captain as always.
Scott Larson, and we are from the Loser Kid Pinball Podcast. And Josh, why are we here tonight?
We are here to present to you the nominees for the 2019 Favorite Topper. And the nominees are...
Black Knight, Sword of Rage Topper by Stern Pinball. Medieval Madness Remake Topper by Chicago Gaming Company. Star Wars R2-D2 Topper by Stern Pinball.
And Josh, the winner of the 2019 Best Pinball Topper TWIPY is...
Black Knight, Sword of Rage Topper by Stern Pinball.
Wow, the Black Knight Topper won a TWIPY for Favorite Pinball Topper of 2019. I'm Steve Ritchie, and I am happy, proud, and thrilled to work with Team Stern on this topper project. I am so grateful to Elliot Eisman, Harrison Drake, Kevin O'Connor, and Tim Sexton for helping create the best topper ever. Thank you for this award, and stay safe.
Congratulations to you, the Black Knight himself, Steve Ritchie, for providing us with an excellent topper for the year of 2019. Such a great addition to the game that I saw in Expo. Definitely caught my eye. Very amazing. And speaking of amazing, let's go on to our next category, which is Favorite Pinball Podcast.
Ooh, and I love this category because podcasts hold such a near and dear place in my heart because I drive everywhere. And I listen to podcasts constantly. Shout out to Nate Shivers from Coast to Coast Pinball Podcast. He's one of the reasons why I got so captivated by this awesome community and hobby. So presenting...
Who ever heard of a snails berry?
On your butt.
Don't podcast, what? Well, what do we have here? Well, it's the TWIPY Awards. Center stage, none other than the grand champion of all pinball media, Macho Pinball. Oh yeah, well here I am in the flesh. I know you've been wondering, so bask in my macho glory. Hey, sorry to cut you off, Imoto, or whoever you thought was gonna present, but what better presenter to announce the favorite pinball podcast than the king of all podcasts, Macho himself. Yeah.
Favorite Pinball Podcast. Canada's Pinball Podcast. Special Winlet Pinball Podcast. This Week in Pinball Podcast.
Whoa, Mr. Silky Smooth, Mr. Butter Voice. Before we announce the winner, Macho is to pay his respects, my respects to the competition. Only one of you will win Favorite Pinball Podcast, but you're all winners in Macho's book, so I come bearing gifts to all my fellow podcast brethren. Take this, it's dangerous to go alone. Canada, I bestow upon you one free Macho Brand Strategy Workshop session. May my infinite marketing wisdom help guide your message in the future. Special One Lit Pinball Podcast. I bestow upon you Big Miss Mona's podcast shovel, should you ever need to dig up that now-defunct podcast. And This Week in Pinball Podcast, I bestow upon you a coupon for one medium, one topping pizza, plus two drinks, as well as one card for 45 minutes of play points to Chuck E. Cheese. May this gift, may it help you bind the ties that break. So much old bravo to you boys. If it weren't for you, I wouldn't be here right now, hacking the TWIPYs. Your contribution to the hobby, it's an inspiration to many. So enjoy the spotlight, because 2020 is a year of macho. Oh, yeah. Hey, Jeff, you can have your little show back now, because macho is out.
And the winner is Canada's Pinball Podcast.
Really? Okay, so this just proves my point, guys, that this is obviously people's choice. We didn't pick this. All of you out there picked this guy. He doesn't even own a pinball machine. Not a single one. Nothing. Nothing in his game room at all. Okay? Nothing. This is it. And then he calls everybody else, you know, morons for buying machines before they play him. And what's he do? He buys a Rick and Morty, guys. Number 50 at that. Buys it. Hadn't played it before. Buys it. But then he wants to call other people dumbasses. Just a little bit hypocritical there, guy. Just a little bit. And then you wonder why Stern doesn't come on your show? You wonder why? Gee, let me just make a 3-minute video explaining why Stern won't come on my show. And you can obviously tell that he's got nothing else better to do. He's obviously in quarantine because he's got a 3-minute long video of all of that. I don't even want to explain what all of that was, but it's all in there. He obviously put some time and effort. You know, I digress. It's whatever.
So, our next category is best artwork, and our presenter is... Cary, who's our next presenter?
Our next presenter is Damien from Haggis Pinball.
Best artwork.
G'day everybody, hope you're doing well and enjoying the show. The nominees are...
Elvira's House of Horrors by Stern Pinball. Artwork by Greg Freres. The Monsters by Stern Pinball. Artwork by Christopher Franchi. Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory by Jersey Jack Pinball. Artwork by John Yousey.
And the winner is...
The Monsters by Stern Pinball. Artwork by Christopher Franchi.
Oh, hi. I was asked by the TWIPY committee to make this video accepting an award that I have no idea whether I've won or not. For best artwork on the Monsters. The reason we're pre-recording this video is because of stupid coronavirus. On the other hand, if you're watching me now, that means I won. Yes! So I'd like to thank you for voting, first and foremost. I really appreciate it. I cherish this award more than you'll ever know. I'd also like to thank John Borg, Dwight Sullivan, Greg Freres, and George Gomez at Stern Pinball for putting out an amazing machine. Thanks very much, and have a great night, everybody.
Congratulations to Christopher Franchi for winning the TWIPY Award for Best Artwork. Artwork was great on the Monsters, Chris. It's very well-deserved. And art can go a long way, but what can really push a game is the next category, which is Best Playfield Gameplay and Layout.
And presenting this category is my rock star friend. That was my attempt to do a triple mohawk with my braids. You know her as Antoinette Johnson. She doesn't have a mohawk in this video, but she's standing in front of her bonsai run, which she almost died trying to get. Play the video.
Best Playfield Gameplay and Layout.
Hi everyone, this is Antoinette coming to you from Orlando, Florida, and here are your nominees for Best Playfield Gameplay and Layout.
Elvira's House of Horrors by Stern Pinball. Lead designer, Dennis Nordman. Jurassic Park by Stern Pinball. Lead designer, Keith Elwin. Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory by Jersey Jack Pinball. Lead designer, Pat Lawler.
And the winner is...
Jurassic Park by Stern Pinball. Lead designer, Keith Elwin.
Much like Iron Maiden before it, when I would go into Keith Elwin's office and play his first whitewood of Jurassic Park, I was smiling the entire time I play it, and this is in a state where it's got no artwork, no rules, no sound. We're just flipping balls around the physical design. I would walk out of his office smiling and I would come back the next day looking forward to shooting it again. Keith and the entire rest of the Jurassic Park team just really did a fantastic job with that design, with the toys and all the different elements on the playfield. That spinner on the premium for the helicopter blades, which I like to call the L-spin, that was just such a unique and brilliant design, and it was something so simple. The Raptor pen was another thing I thought was just a great use of that space, and it really feels like you're capturing a ball in a cage. And of course, the dinosaur mechanism is probably the best mechanism we may have ever done at Stern. We've done some good ones over the years. On behalf of the entire Jurassic Park team, thank you so much for your support. Thank you for your votes. On behalf of Stern Pinball, thank you also for your continued support and patronage, for playing our games, for your passion that we certainly share with you, and we look forward to bringing more great games to you in the future.
Congratulations, Jurassic Park team, yet again. Cary, how many awards did they win this year? My goodness. Well, we're on our last category of the show. Last category of the year. But before that, a quick message from Jeff Patterson from This Week in Pinball. Take it away, Jeff.
Hey guys, just a quick round of thank yous. Thank you to our sponsors, Marco Specialty, Coin Taker, Pinball Star, SilverballSwag.com, and ThisWeekInPinball.com. Huge thanks to the TWIPY committee members, Joel Reeves, Steve Bowden, Lloyd Olson, Zach Minnie, Greg Bone, and Will Auding. Special huge thanks to Will Auding. He's a super genius who has helped a ton behind the scenes with the security for the TWIPY voting. Big thanks to Ed Vanderveen and all the people at the Texas Pinball Festival, like Richard and Howard Barnett, that were helping back when we were going to do the live show. So thank you guys. Huge, huge thank you to Imoto and to Cary Hardy. You guys rocked it. Thank you for all of your work to make this a great show. Hugely appreciate it from all of us. Thank you all the presenters and everybody that helped with the production of the show. Thank you to all of the pinball content creators like podcasts and YouTube channels and streamers and all the operators and arcades and tournament directors and everybody else that makes this hobby great. Thank you all. Biggest thank you of all to the pinball manufacturers and all of you guys that work creating these amazing machines that we get to play. Thank you all so much. Without you, we obviously would not be here. Finally, thank you to all of you watching. Thank you to all of you people that support and read This Week in Pinball. Very much appreciate it. I hope you all have enjoyed the show. If you have any feedback, you can send it to thisweekinpinball@gmail.com while it's fresh on your mind. And don't worry, next year we'll all be at TPF, doing the show live again, hanging out, going out to eat, shaking hands, playing pinball together. Thanks guys, back to the show.
And now, the moment you've all been waiting for. The biggest award of the year, and an award I want all of you manufacturers to strive for, and that is Game of the Year. And the nominees are...
Game of the Year. Elvira's House of Horrors by Stern Pinball. Jurassic Park by Stern Pinball. Willy Wonka and the Chocolate Factory by Jersey Jack Pinball. And the winner is... Jurassic Park by Stern Pinball.
Hi, I'm still Keith Elwin, and I'm here with my award-winning game, Jurassic Park. I'd like to say thanks for everyone for voting, and it's really an honor to win Game of the Year 2 years in a row. Park was truly the best thing I've done so far, but just wait, I've got more coming. Thanks so much from me, definitely Keith Elwin, and this game, Linus McPants. Thanks, everybody.
Bravo! Congratulations to Stern, Keith Elwin, and the whole Jurassic Park team for putting together a great game. Was there ever any doubt that this one would win Game of the Year? I never doubted it for a second. So congratulations to all of you out there. Thanks for joining us tonight. That is the end of this award ceremony. I don't know what else I need to say besides thank you for joining us. We had a great time. Imoto, do you have anything you want to say?
Yeah, we love you guys. Thank you for being with us. Thanks for being in the chat room, for encouraging us to still make this award show with everything going on around us. Stay healthy, stay safe out there, and we'll see you guys soon, I hope.
Yeah.
Play lots of pinball.
Stick around the chat room to chat with us, as well as check out some of our bloopers during this whole recording session.
Bye, guys.
Peace out. Congratulations, Papa Pinball, for winning Best YouTube Channel for Pinball Relations. That's not what I want to say either. Okay.
I'm ready. The people's choice awards. Yep.
Voulez-vous coucher avec moi, c'est pas.
Hey! Why are you doing this to me?
Almost fell off the stool.
I don't know. Favorite competitive pinball player. Let's do that again.
So let me give you a quick overview on how this award ceremony me sideways. All right, hold on.
Come with me and we'll be in a world of pure match.
So let me give you a quick overview of how this works. We have an online... This is a People's Fucking Choice Award, Cary. Why the hell can't you say this?
Our next category is Best Theme Integration. Not to be confused with best... Fuck you, Jeff Patterson. It's all your fault.
What is our next category, honestly?
And he's gonna go, what's up, internet?
I got kind of distracted because I thought he grabbed for a bottle of bottle of Jameson. That's what it looked like at first. I was like, damn, Jeff. I was like,
I'll make it fast. Okay, that's what he said. All right. Hey, faster is better. Got shit to do. All right.
Not even the top three guys? What? What the fuck?
Moving on to the next category is Best Animations and Display, and presenting that.
Yes, and who we have presenting this award are, damn it!
My mama says I'm sassy!
Texas, keep reeling in those awards. So, what's our next category?
Let's move on to the next category, which is... tournament competition! Favorite pinball tournament and competition. I know, I forgot what it was.
F*** you, Jeff Patterson.
Isn't it? You're This Week in Pinball, you should know that.
We should have like a little tally thing every time we say F*** you, Jeff Patterson.
Jeff's going poopy again.
The next category is, I don't know.
Who let the dogs out? Who? You did, sucker.
And that's gonna be our next basic, damn it.
Someone's mowing the damn lawn like it's Sunday.
Category, I couldn't remember that. I couldn't think of the word category.
I just wanna say that is my favorite rod of 2019.
When it comes to best gameplay layout and what the f*** is it supposed to be.
And then Jeff talks for about an hour, and then...
And it really helped the game a lot. So, that's not... I hate to say that, because now I feel like the game is shit, and the only thing that carried it was the artwork, so I'm not going to say it that way.
That was kind of lame, right?
And this is another good reason why we didn't do this live. Because of stuff like this could happen. My dogs could want to go potty. My dogs could want to come barging in here. My internet could drop. Imoto's dad could be washing the car. This is why we did it this way, guys.
Our next category is BAM, Favorite Pinball League. Let me do that one more time.
I managed to get my daughters with a babysitter, but I just don't know how long. So that is one obstacle that I'm glad I don't have to deal with right now.
Round up all your folks and start voting on the TWIPYs, the 2000 TWIP, 2000, f*** you, Jeff Patterson.
Congratulations to you, Jonathan, for best publication regards. Oh, damn it, we'll do that again.
And we'll take a moment right now to remind you guys that this is People's Choice Awards voting. I need a break.
Which is something I should mention. All right, let's try that again. All right.
2020 TWIPY Awards is just waiting for you to log on and vote. It's not really ready yet, but it's not waiting yet. It's not.
All right, another text.
Last one, whatever I say, we're going to keep it. All right. Don't touch your face. You have COVID.
Wins an award this year for best, not best favorites. All right.
The Pinball Podcast Watch. Podcast Watch.
Wins a favorite. God, son of a bitch. Charlotte.
Kick. We don't do podcasts, Cary. We're video.
I will beat your dog. What the hell? Like, she's like wanting in this room. She never wants in this damn room.
Ha, you messed up.
That's number 33 of you, Jeff Patterson.
Welcome to the Pinball Podcast.
This thing is absolutely amazing. And that's where I just kind of fade off.
And who do we have presenting that category, Cary? Because I can't remember right now.
Which leads us to our next podcast. Our next podcast, really? Damn it! Okay.
Play for layout and gameplay.
Once I saw Jeff doing this, I said best. Damn it.
Just look happy. Just look pretty over there, Cary. Do your best.
Take 65.
Best playfield gameplay and layout. Wow, I said that.
game known as Sword of
Rage. All right, short, quick and easy, fast and short.
I bet I know what I'm seeing on these damn things. It's when my dogs come in from outside and they shake off.
Woo! Are we done? Shit, I gotta edit all this. We didn't even congratulate Kaneda for winning.